Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Welcome to Piccadilly Stampin'. I'm Pamela Pick. This is my husband, my husband, Bill. He's joining. So today he was able to go in early and he was racing around. He got done early, but he was racing around so he could be back here to join
us
today.
That's right, because I like being here.
So this, normally I do a quick little card for my Piccadilly Parfait. And for those of you who are joining, if you don't know what a Piccadilly Parfait, it's usually my shorter videos. And, but this one's going to be a little bit longer today, and I apologize ahead of time. Usually I call it a crafternoon sweet treat to just get a little demo in for you guys to provide some information for the, or inspiration for the weekend. But, today I just wanted to, get the simple card out, show you how to do it. And so it's just going to take a little bit longer. So if you're new, be sure to say hello.
Hi, Madison.
Tell us where you're from. We appreciate having you. And like and follow us.
Cheryl McGovern. Hello.
Hello, everyone. So again, this is going to be one of my simpler cards. I'm going to start off and just show you the DSP that we're going to be using. We got two. This is from my paper share. Every time a new catalog is released, I do a paper share, and I actually participate in it because it saves money for me and for my customers. So this is the Joyful paper. It's a specialty paper. It is not double-sided. It does just have the one side, but it has this beautiful, this is the one we're going to be using today. It's got music notes, and it's got this beautiful gold foil on it. And then the other one is the Joy of Christmas. Now, I chose Christmas cards this year because for this technique, simply because people need a lot of cards kind of quick. And sometimes you just don't know what to do. You get a stamp set and that's the one you make for really special, you know, but then there's so much fun to do, but sometimes you need them quickly. Like you get a card from someone, oh, I forgot about them. So this is going to be really helpful because we're going to make six cards at once.
Six.
Yeah. So wow. The paper that I chose to go with this, from the Joyful, is this one with the little music notes here?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, the wood.
Hey, that's from the paper share.
It is from the paper share.
I helped put it together.
Yeah, he's proud because he helped me this year. And then this one with the holly berries on it.
I mailed them too.
He did mail them. And I think you actually went to Quincy to mail them, didn't you? So that they'd go quicker.
Go quicker, yeah.
That's right. So thank you for that, Bill. So I have those. I'm gonna pull those out. And I'm going to grab the pack. Now, we're going to use a piece of thick basic white. I wanted it to have the white background is what I chose for my project. I've got it cut at 4 1/4 by 11 so that you're cutting your DSP or your cardstock right in half. And we're just going to make a base. Now, you can, if you want to score it to make it easier, for me, I actually, believe it or not, I actually do better if I just fold it in half. I don't know why. Sometimes, though, be sure to use that bone folder so that it gives a good burnish because it also helps smooth out those little crinkle lines on the thick cardstock. So I wanted to show you that. The next thing that I want to do is I want to show you the Merry Melodies. It's a 3D embossing folder. Because this paper has this music notes in it. I wanted to mimic that with this. So I went ahead just to save some time and I embossed these. Now I have the other cards here and I'll pull out this base while I've got it. We're not going to do all the cards. I do have some done because these are actually going to be some of my Christmas cards this year. I did not purchase the set, the bundle set that goes with this, but I was in the paper share, so I had it. This is another way I'm trying to help you use your paper shares when you do them. If you don't have the set, maybe I'll get it down the road. I don't know, but I don't have it currently. So this is another way to use your paper shares. So I'm going to move that out of my way. So this is cut at 4 by 5 1/4. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to, there's a debossed and an embossed side. And I'm going to put the embossed side facing up, but I am going to use, I got a little, Look at that thing.
Wow.
A little glue. Yeah. I must have been really gluing something before. I've been making quite a few cards recently, so.
She's been busy.
I have been busy. I've got so many things coming up. I'm hoping to get a game night. I've got most of that done. Game. Yeah. And I'm going to have...
Am I going to be the drawer?
You can be the drawer. I've got a few more prizes than I normally do, too. So we'll get that going probably not till next month. Okay, so I just adhered this. So I like to use the green glue just because I can move it around. But this gives us that background. Does that show on camera? And am I in the right?
Yeah.
Okay, because I can't tell if it shows. It's a really neat, just little music note. So let's set that aside because that's our base. And let's bring in our paper trimmer. I love this paper trimmer. So I'm going to start off with this specialty paper because it's only got one side. And I've made this really easy for you. I don't know if I should set it out here or not. So I made a template because I want you guys to be able to do this. And I will take a picture of this and post this on my blog so you'll have the measurements. But what it is you're going to start with your paper. And I want to cut, let's just look at this together. I want to cut 2¾ right away because I'm going to cut this piece off. And I'm doing this on purpose, like so measure twice, that I'm pointing this out to you because I made a mistake the first time I was doing this. So I want to check it again. It's 2¾ this direction. This is my 6-inch piece of cardstock because it's a 12x6 originally. So I'm going to cut it the 6-inch side right here. Okay, 2¾. All right. Now, let's take a look at this. Now I need 1¼, and I need 2 of those, it looks like. But as you see, here is where I made my mistake, and I'll show you later on in this video. But this little piece right here, it's toss away this quarter-inch edge. So I'm going to start with tossing that away, this little quarter-inch edge. And I'll do it this side, I guess. And the reason why is because my cards didn't have the exact look that I wanted. Now, this is a great little piece, but I don't have anything. I'm going to say it served its time and throw it into my trash bin. Now, coming back over 1¼, we're going to cut here. Let's put this aside. Well, maybe. My nails are so run down these days. 1¼ again. Because I need 2 of these. Okay, now because I had that little quarter-inch piece that I was telling you about, because I had that, I went and split it, and then it was too long for the project. Now I can split it at half, and it needs to be 1 5/8. So 1 5/8. Let's measure again. 1 5/8. There we go. So that should split this right in half, and now I'll have those two separate pieces. Okay, that was easy to do. So these two in one pile, these two in another. Now if we come back here, we're going to see that we need 1 3/8. So I'm going to pull my 6-inch side again in here. 1 3/8. So measure it twice. 1 3/8. Get yourself into the habit and then you don't of measuring twice and you don't make as many mistakes. So 1 3/8. Okay, and then this one says that it needs to be cut at 3, so we're just going to cut it at 3. Okay, pretty easy, right?
Yeah.
It's just cutting paper. It's really not that difficult. Now, I have a super fresh blade in here because you need to cut 3 pieces of cardstock the same way. Or not cardstock, DSP. Yes, oh, okay. 3. Now this is double-sided paper, but I am going to be using these sides of it because I want it to match this. So we're going to do this again, but I'm going to do 2 pieces at a time. So
2 pieces at a time.
I'm going to do 2. Oh, just I really
so efficient over there.
well, I just really want to make sure that everyone's understanding. You know, I always try to teach, right? That's the whole purpose, is just to share. So let's cut it again. So I cut two. Okay, there's my two. I'm going to turn this right away because I want you guys to just toss that piece. It makes a difference. So you just need 1/4 inch trimmed off. There it is. Measure twice. Well, I kind of knew that one. And then we're going to go, just like this says, 1.5. So just follow.
That's 1 1/4.
Or 1 1/4. Yeah, thank you. 1 1/4. These two pieces go here. Let's do it again. 1 1/4. Thank you for correcting me.
Well, yeah.
It wouldn't. Okay. And then now I should be able to cut these two.
1 5/8. 1 5/8.
Yes.
All right.
All right. You're on it. So measure twice. And then, okay, here we go. Make sure it's pushed all the way up. I think I cut that a little crooked, which is not good. It's because I'm over here. I'm going to do it this direction, and then if I need to correct, I can correct. Okay, so 1 5/8. So 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, I'm going to set that into this pile. Coming back again, we're going to do 1 3/8. I know that this is a lot of cutting, but I'm telling you the rewards on this. So 1 2 3, measure twice. 1 2 3. And then turn around and cut it at 3. Is Nick on here saying she's confused already?
No.
Good.
Trying to buy a car.
Oh. Okay. So that was pretty simple, right?
It is.
I'm hoping that really does help. So now, and I don't have the best handwriting. I did make one little mistake here when you see this, but I'm using 3 coordinating DSPs to cut to these measurements, adhere to a mat of 3 1/4, and I had 3 3/4, but it's 3 1/4, so I tried to make it look like a 1 by 4.5 of a coordinating color, and add to the card base of your choice. So I chose real red with this.
Mm.
You like that?
That's bright.
That's your favorite color. Mm-hmm. So let's just start there. So we're going to have one piece that was this bottom piece, which will fit here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then we're going to have one piece, which is this top piece, which will fit here. And actually, I'm going to do this one, I think, because I want that. We'll do this one. Okay. And then we'll do one piece that is here. Like so. Right? So simple. Now you got all these other pieces cut for this. You're going to just kind of shuffle them around. So let's start. And let's add this on. So this is why this paper has a lot of music notes. So I thought this would go really good with that music notes embossing folder. What did you think?
I like it.
Is anyone having any questions or saying anything?
You
guys tell me. Give me some love. Let me know if you like it.
Tools.
Yes. I love our trimmer. It is probably the most accurate when you're not on camera cutting something crooked.
Yeah, if Ireland would just get on the Imperial.
Yeah, it's that Ireland that's, yeah, they're the ones. They drive on the wrong side of the road over there, Bill.
Well, yeah.
And too fast, may I add. And their roads are little, teeny, tiny roads. Right?
Yep.
Right, Nick? You've sent me some videos, so I know. Okay.
Oh, she videotaped herself driving?
That would be a scary thing right there. Okay.
Before or after her car blew up?
Her car blew up? Is that what she's saying?
Said to have a gasket go out of the head gasket.
Oh, shoot.
Yep.
That's unfortunate. Sorry to hear that. Okay, so now I'm placing these on here.
Looks like a stack of Christmas packages. You're right, Cheryl, it does.
It does. But it's really easy. I've just cut straight lines, and now I've got this on here, right? Now, I like to, you guys know, I like to mail things that are very flat. So I'm going to adhere this right down in the middle of this.
Using the green glue.
So it's really just a cut and shuffle. Actually, France corrected me. I think it's called stack, whack, and shuffle, but I hate that term, whack, so I didn't say it. I call it a cut and shuffle. Works for me. Okay, so now you've got a really fabulous, right?
That's right.
Background. Okay, put it aside. Now, normally I would do that step. I would adhere them all.
Times.
Yes, because there'll be enough, and I will show you, but I want to show you something else. So this is the Above It All Dies and Above It All stamp set, which is a bundle that you can purchase through Stampin' Up. Now, I'm not using the bundle. I haven't even opened these yet. I will use them, but today I just wanted that Happy Holidays, that double-decker Happy Holidays. You could do the Warm Winter Wishes, but for the size and what I wanted to create, I just chose the Happy Holidays. So let me get this. This is available right now with our new catalog, our mini catalog. So let's put this on a block. You guys, I don't know if you've noticed, but I use a larger block. This is my personal preference. I like it because I can see through when I'm stamping. Now on this, it's not so necessary. I'm going to open up a drawer here. Hopefully I'm not making that camera go too wild. Yeah, I did. I'm just going to pull out a piece of cardstock and my Stampin' Pierce mat. And let's go with, what should we get? Should I do real red? I think I'm going to do real red. Let's pull out the real red ink because that's the base that I had there. And I'm going to stamp the Happy Holidays. And I want to make sure that my... There we go. My image is stamped. I love the font. I don't know if I have that up high enough. I may try another one before I put all this up. Let's go up a little higher in case my punch. So I like to use punches a lot just because they're quick. I love my die cutting machine, do not get me wrong, but if I can do, this is like one of my favorite cards of all time because I can do them fairly easily and fairly quickly. And especially if you're a new stamper and you don't have cut and stamp emboss, what's the machine? Stamp and cut emboss machine. There we go.
Mini or big?
Well, there's a big and a mini, but... Okay, so I'm just going to use, and these are low in stock right now. This is the 1 3/4 inch punch. Let me put that scrap away, and then let me grab another scrap of real red. Here we go. Do a half of a scrapper. I do, you guys. I really, truly do. What'd you say?
It broke right there.
Oh. Bill just broke my chair.
I'll fix it.
Okay, so there. Well, it's an old base that I started. And I'm going to grab this handmade tag. And I'm just going to punch that out. This is what I chose. Now, again, normally I would have stamped 6 of them and I would have punched out 6 of these. And I'm just going to adhere this right onto here. Now, with this punch, you can have it be in this diamond shape or you can have it be in this square shape. I love it. I personally love circles when I'm doing sentiments because I can stamp them, punch them out, and still get them straight on my project. I'm just going to adhere the sentiment right down, and I am choosing square.
Okay.
So
what's the stamp set called again?
It's called, let me grab it here. Let me put this on. It is called Above It All. And it has, I mean, just look at the font. Let's adventure together. Here's a season full of cheer and wonder. Plus, I'm in love with this tree. I don't know what I like about this tree, but I do. Happy holidays and warm winter wishes.
That's something I'm making my shop.
It is. It does, doesn't it? It kind of looks like our Christmas tree. Okay, so now that I have that done, I'm going to reach up here and I'm going to grab this satin-edged ribbon. It's kind of like, now you guys, I mix metals all the time. I also mix white and off-white all the time. It doesn't matter to me, so I hope it doesn't matter to you. But when you take a piece of this, it's got kind of a little bit of a gold in there, which I thought really looked nice against this. You can take about a 3-inch piece. So, and I've got this cut this way, so I'm gonna just cut it like that so it's similar and fold it over. Why did I do that? You don't need a lot of ribbon. Is Jackie on? I'm going to pick on her about ribbon again. Sometimes it's just a cute little texture element. So she might be.
Yeah, there's 33 people on. So
Jackie, if you're on, say hello. So you can have them going opposite. You can have them going the same. It doesn't matter. But I just used a little bit of Stampin' Seal. And I'm going to place it kind of at an angle, I think. So I think I'm going to go like that. And you can cut it. I think I want it a little bit shorter. This is
so cool.
Yeah. Isn't that neat? It is neat.
It is neat.
Then I can pull my base back in. And let me grab some dimensionals.
Gotta have the dimensionals.
You know me. I over-dimensionalize. Don't care. It's what I feel is important in my crafting, but probably could have got by with 3. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and pull this, and I'm going to just place it kind of converge somewhere in here. Now, each one of these are going to look different because each, you've got one cut for each card that will be different. So, and I will show you that here in just a second. Let me add that down. So again, this was the satin edged ribbon. It's got the gold in it. Very, very, very pretty. Okay, where is my embellishments? So we've got a lot of different embellishments you can use. There's a couple different gold sequins. I love the gold sequins. So what I want to do is use them because we've got the gold there and the gold here. You can use them however you want to, but I kind of have a couple of things that I stick with. And on this one, I think it might look good to have a couple here, a couple there. See, that's already got the gold. I'm going to go here. So I'm just going to put a couple. I like the uniformness of having it up at the top like that. You could also, if you wanted to, put a sentiment on the inside. The stamp set had, you know, here's to a season full of wonder and cheer would be really pretty on the inside with this. I mean, it's a fun stamp set. I haven't used it yet, but this is super simple. Now, let me show you something else. We're not done yet. And I've got all these pieces now to make more cards. I just have to line them up. So here is, let me stop. Let me show you. I want you to notice right here. So I have a separation there and there, and I was going to explain to you guys about how to make sure to cut off that little 1/4-inch piece that I was talking about. Here's the difference. So these came together. They're still beautiful cards. They're still going to work, but they had to come together. Here's another one. That's the same setup as this. Here's another one. They came together because I forgot to take out that little piece. So this right here, toss away that 1/4-inch edge right there. Toss that away. Start with that so you know that you're getting that out of there. But now I've got a rotation of these cards, and you can get 6 of them from those cuts. So I will post this on my blog for you guys to copy it
6
off.
6 cards.
Awesome. 6, yeah, 6 That's cards. Deal. And so now I'm going to have
your time.
Yes. Now, if you don't have this DSP, but you have your own DSP, great. Use it. Use what you have. I just don't have the stamp sets to these. They are kind of intricate, and I really like simple, so I wanted to show you guys kind of a simple way to do it. I do prefer it having the separation in between, but this is still a beautiful card, and I will still use it this season to share with everyone. So the only thing that I really have, I don't really have announcements. Just if I provided you any kind of inspiration, if you're watching me here on Facebook.
DSP? You started out with one that was 12 by 6.
You can use, yeah, I was using a 12 by 6. It just has to be 6 inches on one edge is where I started. And that is, I'll make sure that I write that on here. I was using a 12 by 6, but as long as this edge is 6 inches, and I will write that on there so that's, you know, I'll put the size of both of these on here, on both of these edges. But what was I saying, Bill? Oh, if I provided any inspiration today, please like, share, and follow me. I would so much appreciate it. And if there's anything that you would like to purchase, the paper shares are over. Oh, wait. I had somebody back out. I do have one paper share left and available. If you're interested, message me here on Facebook. For that paper share, and I can get that out to you right away. It's all cut and sealed and ready to go.
And I can go put it right in the mail.
There you go. So, but if you see anything that you would like to purchase here today, you can purchase it from my online store. Just use my host code. This is the current one that I have now, unless your order is over 150. And the reason why I always say that is because 150 counts as a host, code, and so like you would be the host of your own party, and then you get 10% back, which is $15 of free merchandise. So I want you to have it if you're spending that much with me. I hope you guys have a great weekend and can use this in your crafting. Would you leave a comment and tell me if you're going to give this a shot? I sure would appreciate it. Take care, everyone. Have a great day.
Have a good weekend. Bye.
Bye.